holistic nutritionist here at the Energy Shack to give you truths that you need to know about your immune system and how do we keep it strong. Our best defense against any virus, any disease, is always a strong immune system. So here we are, when we're recording this video, it's September 2020, and there's a pandemic going on, and I want you to have some truths that you need to know on how to keep your system, your white blood cells, fighting disease, because that's your best defense. There are five different things that I want to share with you today. Number one, I want you to always remember that your life is in the blood. So the number one thing is that you want to have a strong blood system. And when you think about strong blood system, you should be thinking about your dark leafy green vegetables, your beets, all of those things that are very dark in color, high in antioxidants. Your blood loves those. So you want to have lots of leafy greens in your diet. You want to have them fresh, even cooked is fine. Iron can't really get cooked out, so it's okay to cook your spinach and cook your kale. In fact, it is actually better absorbed that way. And you could also do things like adding a bit of chlorophyll to your water. Supplements are not the answer, but sometimes if your immune system is getting a little bit weak, it's good to be able to add those extra supplements if needed. So adding a bit of chlorophyll to your water in the morning is also a great way to get some good greens. You want to have a good, strong blood system. Again, your life, my life, all those cells, your veins are the highway for all your nutrients. It's so important that you have a strong blood system. So that's number one. Number two, oxygen, air. Your body needs tons of oxygen. Where are you gonna get oxygen from? Well, the truth of the matter is that oxygen is found in raw foods, right? Because as soon as we cook our spinach or cook our kale or cook our carrots, as soon as we do that, cook our celery, whatever we're cooking, oxygen is killed. As soon as you slice an apple, you notice that it's getting oxidized, it's going brown, right? So you want to eat foods in its whole state as far as possible. So adding a lot more fresh salads into your diet, adding a lot more fresh foods into your morning before your breakfast, you're getting lots of oxygen. How else do you get oxygen? Guess what? We go outside. So trying to be outside as much as possible is such a great way to get oxygen. The other thing too is that when you exercise, and if you're doing vigorous exercise, you end up breathing heavy. So that also gets more oxygen into the bloodstream. That's why a lot of athletes or people who do vigorous exercise, they almost never get sick because they're doing a lot of vigorous exercise. They have a lot of oxygen into their blood system. You can over-oxygenate the system. It's too much oxidation, that's possible, but that's not where you and I are going when we're exercising. So can you imagine, with the few little bit of information that I've given you, what would be the best place for you to exercise? Correct, outside. So as much as you can, try to get outside to do your exercise. You're trying to do vigorous walking. Running is a little bit hard on the joints, so you want to make sure that you're outside getting some good power walking in, do your jumping jacks, do as much exercise as you can outside, or at the very least, and this is the next important point about oxygen, have your window open. So whenever you can, whether you're driving, whether you're sleeping, we've got to have that oxygen coming through, because oxygen in the bloodstream helps to keep the blood system strong. And this, of course, is what your cells, especially your white blood cells, need to thrive, to grow, and be strong. So my final point on this oxygen, which was number two, my final point is, although it is mandatory right now, September 2020, to wear a mask, wear it where you need to. But when you don't need to wear it, take it off. Breathe. When you're outside, don't walk with your mask on. When you're driving, don't be in your car and have your mask on. The problem with that, and I think we're going to see that as the fall comes in, is that so many people are going to have a depleted immune system because we're constantly breathing in carbon dioxide. That is poison to the bloodstream. We are suffocating ourselves, so we're not getting the oxygen in that we need to, and our immune system is getting weak. I'm not telling you not to wear a mask, but what I'm saying is wear it where you have to, and if you're working all day with a mask on, try to get outside, take it off, take a breather, and when you don't have to wear a mask, you need to take it off because we need oxygen. And especially if you're in a situation where you have to wear a mask all day, how important is it then that you are having raw, live, fresh food in your diet daily? So important. Also, you want to make sure that the food that you're taking in is high in oxygen, but also not suffocating the bloodstream. So that's important too. And we've talked about before, if you've watched my other videos, that your meat, your dairy, your wheat, your sugar, those things suffocate the blood, make it so thick, and you lose the oxygen from the bloodstream. So number three, so important, your blood, my blood, we're made up of almost 65% water. Our brain holds a lot. Our brain is like 75% water. But if you want to keep a strong immune system, you've got to keep enough water in the body. So between your meals, you should drink water and only water. Drop the juice, drop the pop, drop the tea, drop the coffee, drop all of those things. And just drink water between your meals. If your blood does not get enough water, it gets thick, it gets congested, your blood cells can't move around, and when there is a disease, when there is a virus it needs to fight, it can't even get there fast because it has to go, you know, it's like a traffic jam in the blood. The blood's really thick and it can't get up to the place that it needs to fast because the blood is thick. So drinking plenty of water is so important. And again, I know I'm sounding a little repetitive, but your live, raw, fresh food, your big salads, your cucumbers, your lettuce, your celery, they're like 90% water. So how important it is that we are having a lot of those raw foods in the diet before we even jump into our cooked portion of our meal. So water, super important. And we recently talked about using water on the outside of the skin through hydrotherapy, hot and cold showers. That's also important because it gets the blood moving really fast and just zip it through your body so it can find the disease or the virus and begin to fight it because you've given it all the good food it needs to do that. Number four, what you need to know is, in order for your body to fight viruses and diseases, do you know how important bacteria and germs are? Extremely important. Your gut, my gut, needs a lot of good bacteria. And believe it or not, we are way too clean. In fact, I would like you to take a moment and go find that hand sanitizer that's probably in your pocket or your purse or, you know, in every corner of your house or your office, and I want you to read that label. Almost all of them will tell you that they kill 99.9% of germs. That's a problem. I'm not saying that we don't need to keep clean and wash our hands. Yes, we do. But here is the issue of disease coming at us and us not being able to handle it because our immune systems are weak, even if you're eating healthy. But if you are constantly using that hand sanitizer and you're killing germs, it's such a problem. We need germs to keep a strong system. So, you know, we go to the store, our spinach is triple washed, everything is super clean, super easy. We don't see dirt anymore. This is a major problem. Am I telling you not to wash your hands? Am I telling you, you know, to have germs and put your hands in your mouth? I'm not saying that. It is so important to be hygienic and to wash your hands regularly, but constantly, constantly putting sanitizer on our hands is terrible for the system. And outside of sanitizer, we're now using disinfectant everywhere. And this is a problem as well. Our body does need germs in order to fight disease. It helps to strengthen our immune system. It will naturally produce antibodies, which helps. It's like never going to the gym, never working a muscle. Your white blood cells need to be working, and it's the germs that help them to do that the bacteria that's found in our dirt and, you know, just naturally by growing food that helps to grow the good bacteria in our system. So just be cautious about not how much you're washing your hands, because that's important, about using things that kill germs all the time, everywhere, every minute of the day. The last one that I want to share with you, which is super important, and it's the final one of keeping your immune system strong, is stress. Being scared, being fearful, worrying, not sleeping, the body goes into stress. You can listen to all the things that I've said today. You can eat healthy, you can drink your water, you can get your exercise, you can go to bed early. But if you are worried, if you are fearful, if you are overthinking things, if you're overprocessing and worrying about what's gonna happen and how can I do this, and your system is in so much stress that your immune system is being depleted by the minute because you're releasing all this cortisol. Cortisol suppresses your immune system. There are certain things in life that we absolutely cannot control. And so for those things in my life as a Christian, I bring those to God. I'm grateful to God and just ask Him to take care of the things that I can't, because He can see the end from the beginning. Whatever your faith, whatever your circumstance, I'm telling you, things that are out of your control are not worth worrying about. God promises in His word that He works all things for good. So even in a pandemic, even if your car breaks down on the side of the road, somehow God promises He'll turn that into gold. But whatever, again, your faith or your situation, I just want to encourage you that stress will kill you before any bad food does. So it's not worth it. Don't be afraid during these times. Let's instead find new ways to connect. Make sure you smile at each other when you can. Make jokes, laugh out loud. Eat lots of raw, fresh food. Drink your water, get your exercise. Go outside, get some sunshine. And I'll tell you, you'll have an amazing strong immune system that should a germ fall on your body, it would probably fight it right off.